Ah, beautiful look there as we're ready for baseball on this fine afternoon. It's the Braves and Dodgers next. Still one of the best around, even after 52 years now. A look at Dodger Stadium in Southern California. Ought to be a good one here between the Atlanta Braves and the Los Angeles Dodgers. With that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. Matt Vasgersian here with you. Alongside me are Major League veterans Steve Lyons and Eric Karros. And Steve, let's talk about the two starters that take the baseball here tonight.
Yeah, two guys here with pretty good numbers so far this season. Both of them coming in with double digits and victories. So if this winds up being a 3-2, 2-1 kind of game, that wouldn't surprise me one bit.
More from the guys as this one goes along, but first, let's take a look at the starting lineup for the Atlanta Braves as skipper Freddy Gonzalez lines his guys up this way. They'll match up against a guy who's made big strides since arriving stateside, the Korean-born left-hander Hyunjin Ryu. And behind him defensively, the Dodgers will line up like this. So standing in now, the leadoff man, B.J. Upton, and we are ready for baseball. Good crowd on hand as the first pitch tonight is taken for ball one.
First pitch, 7-10.
Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Hitters count 2-0. Grounded foul. Line to the right side, but foul. Oh, and a nice changeup that time gets him to swing right through it as the leadoff man is down on strikes to open up the ball game.
Well, you know you're off to a good start. You've got a guy shaking his head one at bat into the ball game. You know, and if he can keep these guys off balance throughout, he's going to leave a lot of guys shaking their heads before this is through.
Andrelton Simmons will take his cuts now. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. And a fastball in there for a strike, 1-1.
Yeah, that finds a zone, but some of these pitches are getting a little too much elevation. That could come back to bite him.
And he'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. Throw not in time, and that'll go as a bunt single.
First baseman,
Freddie Freeman will get his first shot now with the runner at first following the one-out single.
That runner's leaning.
Here's a first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Due next is Justin Upton as he gets loose in the on-deck circle. Runners on first with one down. That one's in there, 3-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
The 3-1 is on the way. And this will be fouled away. Here's one hit hard to the right side and caught out there at second. As he'll hang on here to record the second out.
Yeah, and on 3-2, it's a good thing that guy on first wasn't running, or this would have been a double play. Pretty fortunate there.
Justin Upton will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And that's in there for strike one. Two out with the man at first. And here's a fastball called for strike two.
No taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
And Upton won't chase that one. It's 1-2.
Well, he watched that one all the way in, and it looked like he almost gave up on it. He's pretty lucky that wasn't called strike three.
And this one will be foul back in among the fans. Another 1-2. And here's a ball hit in the air. Gordon is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. One left for Atlanta. The Dodgers coming up, and we are scoreless. Now the starting lineup for Don Mattingly's Los Angeles Dodgers. It looks like this. They'll match up against a former All-Star here, right-hander Irvin Santana. Now a quick look at how the Braves will align themselves behind him. D. Gordon will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Leading off for the Dodgers, second baseman D. Gordon.
Oh, he checked his swing there and pops this one up. Simmons is there to make the catch, and it's a one-pitch out to start the home first.
He tried to check his swing. Looked like it was going to be a strike anyway, but he couldn't commit all the way. And as a result, he gives him a free out here with an easy soft liner.
So the base is empty here with one away. And here now a tough out in the person of the shortstop, Hanley Ramirez. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Strike two.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
Fouled straight back. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. And Ramirez able to hold off on that one, but he still trails in the count. It's 1-2.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
To two balls and two strikes now.
He showed him that slider running away two times in a row. Now might be a good time to call on that two-seamer running in.
Full count, 3-2.
Yeah, he's still searching for that knockout pitch, but he can't find it here. I think he's going to have to challenge him 3-2.
And the payoff pitch here is hit on the ground down to third. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now.
Batting third, right fielder, Yasiel
Puig. Yasiel Puig will get his first opportunity now, and as you can see, he enters play with that average up near the 320 mark. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Foul back. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2. You started in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. Turned out to be a good take.
And he gets under the 2-2 a bit as this is sent in the air out to straightaway central. And this is taken in by Upton, and that ends the inning. Dodgers down in order. We played an inning. No score. Jason Hayward leads things off now in the top half of the second.
Right fielder, Jason Hayward.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
And it's worth pointing out here with the trade deadline approaching, it's getting to be nervous time for some of these guys. You never know what can happen this time of year.
Evan Gattis will get his first cuts here. Right there for strike one.
And he's probably not going to throw too many first pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1.
What was that?
Now here's the ball skied down the left field line. And two quick outs here in the second.
Batting seventh, third baseman, Chris Johnson.
Chris Johnson will stand in here looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. Good change up there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one.
Come on, Drew, open your eyes. Let's go, Dodgers.
Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. Now for the second batter in a row. This is in the air out to left field. And Kemp has a beat on it as he makes the play to end the inning. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On now to the bottom of the second. And we are tied nothing nothing. Adrian Gonzalez will start things off in the bottom of the second.
First baseman, Adrian Gonzalez.
High in the air and deep down the left field line. But this will land foul just shy of the wall. Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. Upton comes on now and he has it, one down.
And this is all about taking charge out there. That's the center fielder's ball if he can get there. So he calls everybody off and he makes the play easily.
So one away here with the bases empty. And stepping forth is the left fielder, Matt Kemp. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. Up top, it's 2-0. Lays off a fastball, but it's over for a strike. 2-1.
The fastball looks awfully sharp here early on. Sounds sharp, too.
The 2-1 home.
Here we go.
Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two. Now here's a hard hit ball back up the middle past Santana and into center field for a base hit.
Well, he needed a hit like this. Got to get him to snap out of this cold streak. I mean, you're just looking for something to go your way. And that ball, it's not hit particularly well, but it happens to find a hole. He's saying, man, it's about time.
Andre Ethier will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Changeup called strike one.
Come
Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2.
He just might be up there taking pitches, waiting for that base runner to go, but not going to be able to take any more.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
All right, guys, we're going to check this sequence out again on ShowTrack, but I can guarantee you, he doesn't want to see it again. He's got this thing all backwards up there. He looks at the first two pitches. Those are pitches he probably should have swung at. Then he swings at the one pitch that's out of the strike zone.
Juan Uribe will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Kemp not going. Here's the pitch. And the 34-year-old veteran looks at a called strike. It's 0-1. And a good job to lay off the fastball there. Close, but it's 1-1. A little bit outside, 2-1. And a 2-1 slider is looked at for a called strike two.
And you wonder if maybe he was taken there because he thought his runner was going to be moving from first.
Runners off for second. Pitch inside. The throw is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
Wow, they're trying to make something out of this inning after all. He's off and running here with two away, and he gets into second safely. So now all it'll take is a base hit to get us our first run of the game.
And this is swung on and bounced to shortstop. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Dodgers leave one. We'll move to the third with no score. Number seven is ready to go here as we begin the third.
Second baseman, number seven.
High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one.
All right, Dodgers. Woo!
Fouled back. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. One away here to begin the third.
And that's just some bad luck right there. With the outfield at their normal depth, this ball might have gotten down. But with them playing in, well, it's a completely different story.
Irvin Santana will take his first cuts of the ball game here. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Third inning, no score to this point. And it's a called strike to even the count at one. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. There to take it is Ramirez. Throw on to Gonzalez, and that's out number two. B.J. Upton will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at bat. It's 1-0.
Hey, up! Try to open your eyes next time.
That missed close. It's ball two.
Yeah, a little unlucky here to be behind 2-0. Those first couple of pitches haven't missed by a whole lot.
The 2-0. And little doubt about that one. That's in there, and it's 2-1.
And at the plate, if you've got an umpire helping you out, no reason to go after a borderline pitch on 2-0.
Now a ball hit hard but foul as this one forces the third base coach to dance out of danger. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Andrelton Simmons would be next. That's it to short. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. 8 in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. Braves are set down 1-2-3. Home half of the third coming up, no score. A.J. Ellis will stand in, hoping to perhaps pick up a base hit so we can climb over that Mendoza line. And that misses for ball one.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
Let's go, Dodgers!
And here's a fastball in for strike one. 91 miles an hour that time.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. And a great athletic play to get him. Man, wow.
Yeah, and he had to range deep for this one. And you've also got to worry about that ball hitting the lip of the outfield grass. So you got to hang with it just like he did. And he made a nice play.
Hyunjin Ryu will stand in for the first time here. Good movement there on the fastball as Santana gets ahead 0-1. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
This guy is almost no threat up at the plate. I mean, you could get away with fastballs right down the middle if you wanted to.
Oh, look out now. Guys don't like it when you miss up and in like that. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Swing and a miss, and the count goes full 3-2.
Well, this is turning into a real dogfight now.
Payoff pitch coming.
Here we go.
Here's Simmons at short. Throw to first, and Santana's got it working here. Two quick outs.
Now, these infielders have been busy early on, and that's another ground ball out for them. Probably not going to be the last one we see either.
D. Gordon will dig in. He popped out his first time. And a fastball's in there for strike one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Bounced foul off to the right near Davey Lopes, a former Gold Glover himself in the first base coaching box. And this is drifting foul back into the stands. And he missed with it. It's one and two. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
And he changed up on him here, but this is a foul ball. Misses, ball two. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Here's the 2-2 home. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
And this guy won't lay down here because there's two outs and nobody on. He's putting up a good fight.
Now here's a swing and another chance out there at shortstop. Throw not nearly in time as he reaches it first.
And here's a situation where, heck, just make contact. Put the ball in play. You never know. Winds up beating this ball out.
Hanley Ramirez will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch on the way. Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there.
Definitely a steal situation here. When your leadoff guy gets on with two outs, I'd expect to see him go within the first few pitches.
Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. Down low, two balls and a strike. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Swing and a line drive to left. Upton is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. One left for LA. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Andrelton Simmons will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
Shortstop, Andrelton Simmons.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
You just get the sense that he's got it on cruise control out there now. Make it nine in a row, he's set now.
Freddie Freeman will stand in, a lineout victim his first time. Hard hit towards center. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
The minute he hits that, he's thinking it's a base hit all the way, but it's one of those situations where, you know, you get penalized for hitting the ball too hard. And this stayed up long enough to find the outfielder's glove out there.
Justin Upton will try it again. He flew out his first time. First pitch on its way to Upton. Now here's a swing and a ground ball back up the box. Throw will go to Adrian at first, and with it, the side is retired. Down in order go the Braves. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Yasiel Puig will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
Right fielder, Yasiel Puig.
Here we go. Here's Santana right back at it now as he jumps ahead of the leadoff man. It's 0-1. Fastball that time is nowhere close, and it's even at 1-1. And he looks at one in there, 1-2.
All right, Dodgers.
And this is hit hard to the right side, but foul. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out.
Well, that one looked like for all the world it was a sure single leading off the inning. It was certainly hit hard enough, but evidently it was hit a little too hard as it winds up getting flagged down, and that's just a tough break.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And stepping in now, the slugging first baseman, Adrian Gonzalez. And he'll look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. Upstairs with it yet again. It's 2-0 now.
Well, I'm no pitching coach, but I can see that shoulder starting to fly open a little. That ball's really taken off on him.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
And even on 3-0, it's no given that he's going to be taken up there. We've seen him go after pitches in this spot before. He's not going to hold back.
Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. Drifting back behind first now. Number 7 backs up and takes care of it, 2 away.
Yeah, this isn't an easy play for a second baseman. He's got so much to worry about. The first baseman backing up, the right fielder charging in. You know, but this is his ball, and he puts it away without much trouble.
Matt Kemp will dig in. He singled his first time around. Here's a good fastball that time as Santana jumps ahead, nothing and one.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Grounded foul toward the coaching box at third. Late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And on to first with it is Freeman, and that'll end the inning. Stick around because Jason Hayward will lead things off when we come back. Through four, still tied, nothing, nothing. And there is Jason Hayward. He'll look to get something going here in this scoreless ball game.
Jason Hayward.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. There's his total now, just into his fifth inning of work. Nothing too out of the ordinary there.
The pitch count's the least of his worries. If his guys don't get him any runs, I don't think it'll matter all that much.
1-0 on the way. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
Swing and a hard liner to center field. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth.
I think we expected to see a well-pitched game coming in, and we got one. Starting to look like the team who scores first might be the one who wins.
Evan Gattis will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. In there, 0-1. No runs, just one hit, and no errors so far for Atlanta. And he misses with it, 1-1. Up high, 2-1 now.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
Called strike two, and now it's full 3-2. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Wow, just a great at-bat right there. Simple as that. Patient, laid off some tough pitches. He was rewarded.
Chris Johnson will try it again. He flew out his first time. and he gets ahead 0-1. Slider here, but he stays with it and bangs it into center field for a base hit. And the throw will come back in quickly, so it's first and second now with only one away.
And this is something they've worked on in the batting cages, taking some of the movement out of his swing. Much more compact now, and he's seeing some definite results.
Number seven will dig in. 0 for 1 here in this one. He'll start him with a fastball down and in for a ball, 1-0. Getting a few steps off a second there, now the pitch. And now a swing and a routine fly ball out towards center. Ethier is there, two gone. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now.
Now batting, the pitcher, Ervin Santana.
Ryan Domet has moved out into the on-deck circle, so that'll signal the end for Santana in this one. Now a swing and a ground ball. Throw to first is going to be in time, and the Braves rally comes up short as that's out number three. A golden opportunity to get on the board here goes for naught. Back with more on our Wednesday night showcase right after this. David Hale is going to take over here in inning number five, as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep them in the game here. Andre Ethier will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth.
Center fielder, Andre Ethier.
Now some action in the Braves bullpen as they'll stand up a right-hander to get loose. Starts him out with a changeup off the plate for ball one. This is hit sharply to the left side. Oh, but a super diving catch takes away a hit.
Oh, you know this ball was ticketed from left field right there, but look at the athleticism. He closes ground quickly and then pulls this ball in right at full stretch. That's as good as it can be done out there.
Juan Uribe will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
All right, Juan, here we go.
Pulls the string on that one, one strike.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him, because that thing was right down Broadway.
Now an off-speed pitch that nearly ran in and got him.
Sometimes if you let that changeup go too soon, it'll take off on you. He's lucky that didn't hit him.
And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And Hayward will put this one away for out number two.
Well, we're still looking for that first run of the ball game. Thought for a second this might be it, but it just didn't have enough steam behind it.
A.J. Ellis will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now here's the first pitch. In there, no balls and a strike. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. And he lays off for ball one. Lined hard to center field. Upton is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Sixth inning coming up, still zip, zip. B.J. Upton will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips.
B.J. Upton.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. Not close. It's 2-0. And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Here's a fastball that swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. Oh, and this goes right past him. Upton not stopping. He's headed for third. So some real problems out there that time as it'll wind up in E7. Carl Crawford is going to have to enter the ball game here as he'll take over in left following the injury.
Number three, Carl Crawford.
Andrelton Simmons will stand in now. He's singled and struck out in two trips.
Shortstop, Andrelton Simmons.
And a high strike there, 0-1. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing.
Go home, Gray. Go back to Atlanta.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. On the ground toward Gonzalez, but foul wide of the bag. And wow, tough to lay off the fastball there, but it's 1-2.
Oof. That high fastball is definitely a pitch guys will pop up, and that's what he's looking for on the mound. So that's good restraint to hold back and not swing.
And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
And this is all about having faith in your catcher that he's going to block that pitch as well he should. He's one of the best around when it comes to smothering balls in the dirt.
And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
You can just sense him starting to tense up out there on the mound. They had him down 0-2 and now he's struggling to make the perfect pitch, and it's not happening.
Full count pitch on its way. And he's able to lay off there for ball four. And that'll put runners at the corners now with still nobody out.
That is just a great at-bat right there. Anytime you go from down 0-2 in the count to working out a walk, well, let me tell you, that ain't easy to do. And that's all about having a really good feel for the strike zone.
Freddie Freeman will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. The catch is made deep in the alley, and here comes the runner from third. And he will score on the sacrifice fly as he's in with our first tally of the ballgame.
In a game like this, you had to figure that a manufactured run was going to be how we finally opened our scoring. Good work there to drive him in.
Justin Upton will stand in with a run in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Swing and a ball line hard towards short. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. Long throw to third. And they're not going to get him at third. So runners at second and third now with only one gone.
You make a mistake up to this guy, he's going to make you pay. This pitch is belt high, and he just jumps all over it and drives it into the alley to put runners on second and third now.
And now we see Dodgers manager Don Mattingly out of the dugout and on his way to the mound. And that will be the last we see in this one of Hyunjin Ryu. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision.
Your attention, please.
And we'll have a new pitcher take over here as it's the former first-round selection out of Miami, right-hander Chris Perez. Jason Hayward will be the first to face him here as he'll stand in with two men in scoring position and only one away. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes.
Very tempting up there, but that's also a pitch that a lot of guys will pop up. So that's a nice job of laying off.
The 1-0. And he looks at a slider in there. 1-1. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Pause. Now the pitch. Hit on the ground towards first. Throw to the plate. The tag from Ellis, and he is out at the plate.
Yeah, and I think, you know, with one away here, you're taught that this is the right idea. Even if you get tagged out, you have first and third with two away. If you stay, you have second and third with two away. So there's not much of a difference. So you might as well try to score anyway. No dice here, though.
Evan Gattis will step in now and see what he can do with two on and two out here in the sixth. Now the first pitch. There's a fastball to start him off, but that misses for ball one. Now it's 2-0.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in the strike zone.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground to short. And that is through into left as he delivers. It's a base hit. And that'll score the run from third as they go up 2-0 now.
You know, sometimes this game can just be flat out simple. Here he just worked his way into a good count, bought himself a nice fastball to hit, and then just rips it out there to drive in a run.
Chris Johnson. We'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home here in the inning so far. In there, strike one.
Yeah, even with two on and two away, this is not a guy that's going to back down out there. He comes right after him with a fastball, and he gets ahead.
Using the fastball exclusively here, it's 0-2.
Right back, same pitch, also knee high. He wasn't buying that one either. He's gonna have to do something now. He's down two strikes.
Close to the bag at second there, now the pitch. Oh, he went for the knockout pitch that time, but a good eye, 1-2. Two down, runners at first and second. And a big strikeout there. They'll leave a couple of runners on base, and after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. So two runs on two hits, one error in the inning, and two left. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Justin Turner is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. And so now the Braves will get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side. But this will be gloved out there at second as he didn't have far to go for the out.
And this is just a pitcher's way of making sure his infielders are awake out there. First pitch of the inning, and this ball's hit pretty hard. But as you can see, he doesn't have that far to go to pull it in.
D. Gordon will stride in, popped out and singled in his two trips. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Now the second pitch of the inning is hit on the ground to third. Oh, and Johnson has some trouble with it. And the throw will be too late as he can't recover in time.
Didn't look like there was anything too special about this ground ball. Just looked like he maybe raised his head a little bit there, and that'll cost him a one-out base runner.
Hanley Ramirez will try things again. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips. And with Adrian Gonzalez just around the corner, we'll see a lefty getting loose in the bullpen now. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one.
And you know, down there at third base, he absolutely wants another shot at a ground ball. Something to try and make up for that error.
Throw over to first, back in standing. Here's the 1-0 now to Ramirez. Pitches a cold strike. The throw not in time as he steals second.
And that may have been an out-and-out guess right there. He had to figure they weren't going to throw over twice in a row, so he's running on first movement, and he makes it to second base safely.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Now a pickoff play at second, and the runner back in standing. No lead to speak of at second. Here's the pitch. Just tried to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2. No runs, two hits, one error in the ballgame for the Dodgers to this point. Now a swing and a miss by Ramirez as he's dispatched back to the dugout, out number two.
Well, you know, it's just the sixth inning, but you kind of get the sense that they need to come up with something here. So that could be a really costly strikeout.
Yasiel Puig will take another shot here. He's flied out and lined out in two trips. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one. A throw behind the runner at second, but the runner's back easily. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Hey, it's danger any way you look at it right here. You've got a base open, but you've got an even better hitter waiting on deck. So I don't think I'd be working around this guy. I'd be forced to go right after him.
Got his 2-0 fastball, but he was way behind. 2-1.
And that's a case where he's just trying to do anything to get his guys on the board.
A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
He was hoping he'd get him to go up the ladder there, but that's going to set up an even more dangerous pitch here on 3-1.
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Big spot here. First and second, two men gone. And now the left-handed hitting Adrian Gonzalez will get a shot. And this is fouled back and out of play.
Come on.
Now a spin and a throw back to second, and he'll be back in standing up. Runner holding tight at second. Now the pitch. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Dodgers strand a couple. They trail things here 2-0. Back here at Dodger Stadium. Seventh inning straight ahead with the Braves leading this one. But before we get it started, let's take a look there at the game summary to this point.
Your attention, please.
New pitcher set to come on now, and it's the veteran right-hander Jamie Wright who gets the call. Number 7 will dig in for the third time now. He started the evening 0-for-2 so far.
Number 7.
Cut fastball in there for a called strike. Curveball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1.
Woo!
swinging a high pop-up. Could be tough back behind third. And Uribe will put this one away for the first out.
And as a defender, these are the kind of pitchers you like to play behind. Someone who pitches to contact, keeps the defense involved, and he gets an easy pop-up right here.
Gerald Laird will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 11, Gerald Laird.
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Not quite reaching 90 with the fastball, but it's 1-1 now.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. Just fire that thing in there.
One pitch on the way. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Oh, nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
And this one's tapped foul at home plate. And this is fouled straight back. Bases are empty, one man out. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Full count, three balls and two strikes.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that one. And now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
And he lays off ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
That's an easy take right there on the 3-2 pitch. Not all that inviting at all. You want to at least make the guy think about hacking up there. Instead, now he's on with one away.
So a runner at first now with one away. And standing in, the speedy center fielder, B.J. Upton. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Upton not able to come up with that one as he falls behind. No balls and two strikes.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like he's trying to get a ground ball here. He's coming right after him trying to get a punch out.
And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Runner at first here, one man out. And Upton swings and misses on a good pitch, and he's set down on strikes for route number two.
This is kind of a tough trade-off here in that leadoff spot. For the most part, he's been a pretty productive hitter at the top of the lineup, but those strikeouts just keep mounting up. And I don't care if you have leadoff-type speed. If you're not putting the ball in play, you're not getting on base.
Andrelton Simmons will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Woo! First offering on the way. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run. Two-run shot to straightaway center. Sixth home run on the season for him. And the Braves add on. It's 4-0.
And this is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Freddie Freeman will stand in, and I've got to think these add-on runs here will really make it difficult to come back from.
And that's how they've done it all game long. They haven't really had a big inning yet, just a lot of ones and twos, but those will add up.
In there, and it's 0-1. The tail of the tape on that last home run, 410 feet.
Here you go, guys.
And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. And he's right on the fastball there, as this is hit pretty well out towards deep left. Crawford will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. But two in the inning for Atlanta, both coming on this two-run home run. Get up and stretch. Home half of the seventh coming up. It's now 4-0 Atlanta. Luis Avilan will get the ball now, as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seventh.
Luis Avilan.
Carl Crawford will come on, and as he's newly entered into the ballgame, he'll get his first plate appearance now here in inning number seven. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
A lot of late movement on that fastball. That nearly came back to the outer edge.
Big swing and a miss at the changeup, a ball and a strike.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch, and they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
One home now to Crawford, and he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And this is on the ground toward the hole. Oh, a tough play. Throw from a knee is too late, and that will be an infield single.
Boy, what a great effort there to knock this ball down as we check it out again. He knows he's got to get rid of this thing in a hurry, so he tries to shuffle it off to first from a knee, but just no way to get anywhere near enough on that throw to get the out.
Andre Ethier will stand in now in what could be a real make or break situation.
And you think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
Fouled straight back. And there's a swing and a miss by Ethier. He falls behind, nothing and two now. Boy, he sure can sling that thing, can't he?
He sure can. A very wide arm angle, comes from the first base side. It's not straight either, it's moving.
Oh, now here's a drive out to the alley, and they would need a third Upton brother in left center to get this one, as that one's all the way to the wall. And they'll get back a run here as they're on the board. It's 4-1.
Well, you know what? It's not too late to make a game of this after all. They're going to get a run back here on the RBI double, and even though there's not a lot of outs left, at least they're going to make these guys sweat a little.
Anthony Varvaro. Come on now, as he'll take over in inning number seven. Juan Uribe will be the first one to greet him here, as he'll be doing so with the runner in scoring position and still nobody out. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. For Ethier, that's now 14 doubles on the season so far. A high strike there, and it's 1-1. And that's taken for a called strike two.
Now you can't look for a specific pitch. You just got to protect the plate.
And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. No one out with a runner at second. Ethier leads off a second. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and down goes Uribe for out number one.
The catcher.
That was quite a nice little battle as we check out the sequence of pitches here. It was a six-pitch at-bat, and as you watch this, you'll see that he wasn't going to go down without a fight. He was able to keep the at-bat alive by fighting off a couple of tough two-strike pitches. But in the end, finally put away on that pitch right there, 1-2.
A.J. Ellis will stand in, but with the tying run still in the on-deck circle, he needs to get on base somehow. A bit high there, a ball and no strikes. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. And this is hit hard on the ground to first. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Well, at the very least, he does move that runner up to third base. But with two away now, I don't think that's exactly what he was hoping to accomplish. I think he wanted to drive him in.
Scott Van Slyke will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 33, Scott Van Slyke.
Too low, 1-0. Big, slow breaking ball, one that drops in for a strike. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Boy, what a nice job so far of working himself into a hitter's count. Now he can go to work on maybe picking up that two-out RBI out of the nine hole.
A man on third with two down. Now a swing and an easy fly ball out toward right center. And this is taken in by Upton, and that ends the inning. One for the Dodgers here on the Ethier double. Seven complete here tonight. It's the Braves 4 and the Dodgers 1. J.P. Howell will be summoned from the bullpen now, so he'll take over to start inning number 8.
J.P. Howell.
Justin Upton will get us going now in the top half of the 8th.
Left fielder, Justin Upton.
And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing and one. And a swing there from Upton as this is on the ground to short. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Good performance thus far by the visiting Braves. They lead this one in the 8th as you get a look at our line score thus far. Jason Hayward will try again. 0 for 3 thus far. And he hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike 1. One out, nobody on.
Get some water here.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. And a sinker sinks too much there as it bounces into the catcher's glove.
Yeah, and on 2-1 right now, you gotta figure this guy's wound up for the fastball here. Maybe you come with the breaking ball here out of the zone and hope he goes after it.
Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. Oh, and that ricochets off him on the mound as it deflects towards second. And he will recover in time to get it over to first. Nicely done there as they record the second out. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it, it looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Evan Gattis will stand in. He's 1 for 2 so far. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball 1. One 0 pitch is a sinker swung on and missed, 1-1. Jumped the gun a bit on that swing, and he's down 1-2. Eighth inning, 4-1 is our score. Here's the 1-2. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Now a swing and a ground ball for Ramirez at short. Throw on to the first baseman. Gonzalez will take care of him, and the inning is over. Braves are set down 1-2-3, but they lead it 4-1. Jordan Walden is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Jordan Walden.
D. Gordon will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Down 0-2 after two great sliders. He's got his work cut out for him now.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Yep, you saw his numbers there just a moment ago, and he's got that ERA in the low twos coming into play, and he continues to pitch effectively as he retires the first man to greet him here.
Hanley Ramirez will try again, struck out swinging his last time through. And it's the outside corner. It's strike one.
And time's getting short here. You don't want to have to face that closer in the ninth inning needing three runs. They need to cut that gap down somehow.
He dials down on that one, but the result's the same. It's a called strike as he's in the hole now, 0-2. And a swing and a ball hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul.
Here we go.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Another 0-2 home. And boy, what a battle brewing here as he fouls yet another pitch into the seats. Still stuck on 0-2. Hit hard back up the middle. And Ramirez is aboard. Hits a base hit.
With some guys, it doesn't matter if it's 0-2 or 2-0. They take the same approach either way. Well, this right here is one of those guys, and he comes through from being down in the count.
Yasiel Puig will dig in now, hitless in his two at-bats so far. First pitch to him.
Here we go.
And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. And there's ball one. Fastball runs in tight here, and it's 2-1.
I'll give him this. He's not intimidated up there. That was inside. Close to triple digits. He didn't even flinch.
little tapper. We'll see if they try for two. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out.
Yeah, and the only silver lining to this offensively is that you get that guy up to second base and now he's in scoring position with two outs. But I would doubt seriously that that was his intention.
Adrian Gonzalez will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. He could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Watches a fastball right there for strike one. Surprising to you guys that it looks like they're going to pitch to him?
It is to me. I mean, I wouldn't go anywhere near this guy with a base open.
Come on! All right, let's go.
Runner not going anywhere at second. Now the pitch. In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
It shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Now the 1-2. And there's a pitch Gonzalez takes, and we're back even at 2-2. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. That was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Hits are even right now at 5 aside. Short lead from second, now the pitch. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Dodgers leave one, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Chris Johnson will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth.
Chris Johnson.
First pitch coming. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here. Nothing in one. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out.
Now batting, number seven.
Number seven will try again, 0 for 3 thus far. Now a swing here and another ground ball headed to first. And Gonzalez takes this one over to first himself for the out.
Two more ground outs, and that's the product of throwing that sinker. Just about every time you swing at it, you're either going to hit the top of it or miss it altogether. And if you do hit it, you're going to be killing all the worms out there in front of home plate.
Tyler Pastrnicki will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number one, Tyler Pastrnicki.
Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Tries to drop one down here, but he misses. Strike two. Job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. They'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And no one can get there as it falls.
Let's watch this swing in show motion. You're going to see this pitch just tie him up in knots, but somehow he's able to fist it all the way out to right field.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and standing in, the speedy center fielder, B.J. Upton. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one. Looks at a sinker there that drops in 1-1.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And he's got to be careful now that some of these borderline calls don't get him started going downhill.
Yeah, and sometimes it's really easy to dwell on those, but you have to keep looking forward. It's not easy, but you got to do it if you want to have success.
Wait. 2-1 pitch is a sinker swung on and missed. 2-2.
And this is part of the reason why he's staring a hat trick right in the face. He just hasn't been able to recognize these pitches that are well out of the zone.
And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. Struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at bat if they want to get back in this thing. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Braves held off the scoreboard here in the ninth. Last chance coming up for the guys in blue. They trail here 4-1.
Your attention, please.
Ninth inning safe situation coming up now as they'll entrust Craig Kimbrel with the baseball here as he'll try and close things out. Carl Crawford will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Crowds him a bit with a fastball there, and it's to 1-1.
Tough pitch right there. That's 96 in on the hands.
You just got to let that one go.
That's right. Wait for your pitch.
And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2. Pitch on the way. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. Full count now, 3-2.
Yeah, and on 2-2 to start an inning, that's a call you'd like to get.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Freeman is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away.
Well, this is what you want out of your closer. Comes in firing darts, and it's a very quick out number one.
Andre Ethier will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. And a fastball misses here to start the at bat. It's 1-0. That missed. Close. It's ball two.
Boy, I don't know that I'd want to be facing this guy right now. He looks pretty fired up out there.
Yeah, he looks like he could run that fastball through a brick wall.
And he misses again with it here. It's 3-0 now.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
Won't even have to take the bat off its moorings. A four-pitch walk here.
Well, as a closer, you don't want to walk anybody, but obviously that's not always going to be the case. So with one away, that gives these guys renewed hope.
Juan Uribe will dig in. Strikeout victim his last time. High and away on the first pitch fastball there. It's ball one. Runners on first with one down. The 1-0 pitch. Another fastball. This one he gets by him. It's 1-1.
And if you're going to go after that pitch, you got to be thinking right field. I think he just pulled off of that one a little.
Helping him out here as he swings and misses to fall behind a ball and two strikes.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
Swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
In a game like this, you hope that the bottom half of your order can pick up the slack here. But this isn't going to help much. Go grab some bench.
A.J. Ellis will stand in as their last chance now.
There we go.
a fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Look at Ethier, and now the pitch. 2-0 now.
I think he's going out there right now just to remind his guy, hey, this is the number 8 hitter up there. No reason to work the edges. You just come right after him.
Look out, and that'll give him a close shave.
And obviously a walk here would be a huge development in this game with 2 outs in the 9th inning. You don't want to bring that tying run to the plate.
Ruled a strike on the outside corner, 3-1.
And at the plate, he might have been told, look, you're taken until you get a strike. It's not a bad idea.
Good at bat that time as he lays off for ball 4. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with 2 away.
He may be the closer, but he is opening up a real can of worms here. Putting another guy on base with a walk, that's not going to help things.
Number 72 will start to loosen up in the on-deck circle as he'll bat with 2 on and 2 out here. Keeping him close there at second. Now the pitch. Fastball's too high here, 1-0.
Now he's going to have to punch his way off the ropes now.
Come on, go.
Not close. It's 2-0.
And now at the plate with a 2-0 count, it's not just, hey, this has to be a strike. You've got to look for one pitch in one location and then let it rip.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. 2 men are on with 2 men out. Out in front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball. Now the relay home. And he is out at the plate. Trying to get a little too greedy when he didn't need to be. And this ball game is over.
Another good win for these guys. And they're playing some confident baseball out there right now. That's their 4th win in a row. So they've got things firing on all cylinders.
Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close 2-run victory. And as we wrap things up here, what do you say we name this guy right here as the recipient of our Topps Player of the Game Award?
Yeah, you see a couple of hits for him in the ball game. This one was tight throughout, but in the end, he really helped lead his guys to this victory.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, get those smartphones and tablets out and head over to theshownation.com. The Braves are winners here, 4-2. Good night from Los Angeles.